Jain students, today I am going to introduce new chapter, that is quadrilaterals, chapter number 8. Quadrilaterals, everybody knows, a polygon having four sides, a closed figure made up by four sides known as quadrilateral. Okay, classification of the quadrilateral. Quadrilaterals, there are two types, convex and concave. Okay, convex quadrilateral means each interior angle of the quadrilateral must be less than 180 degree and both the diagonals must be inside the quadrilateral. Okay, each interior angle is less than 180 degree and both the diagonals must be inside the quadrilateral. For example, figure, you know, A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. Each interior angle is less than 180 degree and both the diagonals are inside the quadrilateral, known as convex quadrilateral. Concave quadrilateral means one of the interior angles must be more than 180 degree, means reflex angle, and one of the diagonals must be outside the quadrilateral. One of the interior angles is more than 180 degree and one diagonal must be outside the quadrilateral. Figure is like this, A, B, C, D. Interior, one of the interior angles, one angle C is more than 180 degree and one of the diagonals, if you join BD, you get one diagonal that is outside the quadrilateral. Another one is inside the quadrilateral AC, but diagonal BD is outside the quadrilateral. Okay, if one of the interior angles is more than 180 degree and one of the diagonals must be outside the quadrilateral, then it is concave quadrilateral. Types of convex quadrilateral, you know, these are first rectangle, second square, third parallelogram, fourth rhombus, fifth trapezium, sixth kite. This everybody knows, trapezium. Okay, now some important terms we have to use in quadrilaterals that you have to see. Of the quadrilateral will have A, B, C, D. Okay. First, adjacent sides means two sides of a quadrilateral having a common point known as adjacent sides, AB and BC, having a common point B. So AB and BC is a pair of adjacent sides. Similarly, BC, CD, CD, DA, DA and AB. Okay, there are four pairs, AB, BC, BC, CD, CD, DA and DA, AB. So two sides having a common point known as adjacent sides. Second is opposite sides. Opposite sides. Two sides do not have a common point. Like AB and CD do not have a common point. The pair of opposite sides. BC and AD also do not have a common point. So it is also a pair of opposite sides. So AB, BC, BC, AD. Okay. Now come to angles. Adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. Two angles having a common arm. Two angles of a quadrilateral having a common arm. Suppose angle A, angle B. Okay. So common arm is what? Arm of angle is AB, AD. Arm of angle B is AB and BC. So AB is the common arm of both the angles A and B. That's why angle A, angle B are adjacent angles. Okay. So angle A, angle B, pair of adjacent angles. Similarly, angle B, angle C. Angle B, angle C, another pair of adjacent angles. Common arm is BC. Angle C, angle D also. Angle C, angle D. Common arm is CD. Angle D, angle A. So there are four pair of adjacent angles. And fourth is opposite angles. So two angles of a quadrilateral do not have a common arm. Okay, two angles of a quadrilateral do not have a common arm. Suppose angle A, angle C. Okay, so arms of angle A are AB, AD. Arm of angle C are BC and CD. So there is no common arm of angle A and angle C. That's why these are opposite angles. So here angle A, angle C, one pair is angle A, angle C, and second pair is angle B, angle D. Okay, these are the terms we have to use actually. Thereafter, one theorem that sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Okay, everybody knows. Let's see. One theorem, sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So how to prove? Very simple. Given is what? Let A, B, C, D be a quadrilateral. Okay. What we have to prove? Required to prove angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to 360 degree. So draw one diagonal only. Suppose you have drawn one diagonal AC. Okay. So what happened? We get two triangles and you have to use angle some property of triangle. Okay. This angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. In triangle ABC, angle 1 plus angle B plus angle 3 equal to 180 degree. In triangle ADC, angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle D equal to 180 degree. We get two equations. Add both the equations, we get sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360. Very simple, let's see. In triangle ABC, angle 1 plus angle B plus angle 3 equal to 180 degree in triangle ACD, angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle D equal to 180 degree. And thereafter you have to adding angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle B plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle D equal to 180 plus 180, that is 360. So angle 1 plus angle 2 means angle A plus angle B as it is, angle 3 plus angle 4, that is angle C, plus angle D equal to 360 degree. Okay, very simple. We have done this in class 8 also. Now come to your standard. So many theorems are given. Actually, the properties of types of polylateral, all are the theorems. You have to prove a few theorems as per your syllabus. Okay, but you have to go through all the theorems. These are the properties of types of polylaterals. Okay, from NCERT theorem number T, one theorem 8.1, that you have to prove as per your syllabus. It is given to prove theorem number 8.1 in your NCERT book, page number 139. Okay, a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Very simple, like diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay, parallelogram A B C D, a diagonal AC. Okay, properties of parallelogram already have learned in class 7 and 8 also. Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect each other, diagonals are not equal, and sum of adjacent angles is 180 degree. Listen again. Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal. Okay, sum of adjacent angles, one angle A plus angle B, or angle B plus angle C, or angle C plus angle D, or angle D plus angle A is 180 degree. Diagonals are not equal. Diagonals AC and BD are not equal, but bisect each other. Okay, so what you have to prove? Given is what? Let A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. We have to prove diagonal, one diagonal divides the parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Means we have to prove triangle A, B, C congruent to triangle C, D, A. Okay, proof very simple. The opposite sides are equal and AC is common side of both the triangles. Okay, opposite sides are equal, AB equal to DC, similarly BC equal to AD, and AC is common side. So by SSS criteria we can prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay, except the criteria RHS, we can apply any other criteria of congruence by ASA or by AAS, okay, or by SAS also you can prove both the triangles are congruent. So as per your choice. Okay, I have seen all sides are equal, that's why I am using SSS criteria. There is no problem in triangles ABC and CDA. Okay, since AB equal to BC, BC equal to BA, these are opposite sides, and AC equal to CA common. So therefore, triangle ABC congruent to triangle CDA by SSS criteria. Proved. So simple, it is given in your syllabus, that's why you have to do this theorem 8.1. Come to next. Okay, in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Just now we have shown, okay, a diagonal divides a parallelogram into two triangles, two congruent triangles, okay. And on the basis of that, using other criteria of congruence, we can also show both the triangles are congruent, and similarly we can conclude that opposite sides are equal. So property number 2 or theorem number 8.2, that is, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. If each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral are equal, then it is a parallelogram. If each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then it is a parallelogram. Okay, if opposite sides are equal, then it is a parallelogram. Suppose A, B, C, D. Opposite sides are equal, it is given. Okay, so each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then it is a parallelogram. So how to prove it is a parallelogram? Both the triangles are congruent then? By SSS criteria, triangle ABC congruent to triangle CDA by SSS. Okay, then what happened? Angle 1 equal to angle 2. Okay, so therefore angle 1 equal to angle 2 CPCT, but these are alternate interior angles. But these are alternate interior angles. So then what happened? Then AB parallel to BC. Similarly, BC parallel to AD. So opposite sides are parallel. Then what happened? Then it is a ABCD is a parallelogram. In this way, we can prove also, no problem at all. Thereafter, 8.4. In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Okay? 8.5. In a quadrilateral, each pair of opposite angles is equal, then it is a parallelogram. In a quadrilateral, each pair of opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. And in a quadrilateral, if opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. You have to write all the theorems from NCERT, okay? And prove only one theorem is given as per your syllabus, that is theorem number 8.1. Okay, we have done this. So, theorem number 8.5, if in a quadrilateral opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. Converse of 8.4, theorem number 8.4, we have seen that in a parallelogram opposite angles are equal, and converse of this theorem is in a quadrilateral if opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. Thereafter, 8.6. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Now, in a parallelogram, we have to prove diagonals bisect each other. Suppose A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. The diagonals are there. Okay, we have to prove diagonals bisect each other, means O is a midpoint of AC as well as BD. Clear? O is a midpoint of AC as well as BD. Very simple proof. we have to consider two opposite triangles. Okay, you know angle 1 equal to angle 2, parallelogram is given, then alternate radial angles are equal, angle 3 equal to angle 4. Okay, and this side AB equal to this. So what we get, both the triangles are congruent by angle side angle criteria of congruency. Then by CPCT we can say OA equal to OC, OB equal to OD. Clear? You have to prove AOB congruent to COD by angle side angle criteria, and by CPCT we can say that OA equal to OC, OB equal to OD. So diagonals bisect each other, means O is the midpoint of AC as well as BD. Then after 8.7, if diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. In a quadrilateral, if diagonals bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. Converse of theorem number 8.6. In 8.6, diagonal bisect each other in a parallelogram, and converse of that is given in theorem number 8.7. That is, if diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. Clear? So, first exercise, only 7 theorems are there. Now, these are the properties of parallelogram. And thereafter, you have to start exercise. You have to write all the theorems. And theorem 8.1, you have to prove also. Clear? Remaining, you have to write in your class of copy, everybody. Now come to exercise 8.1. Theorems are given in questions also. This exercise, questions number 2. If diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, show that it is a rectangle. If diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then you have to prove it is a rectangle. Diagonals of a parallelogram are equal given. Then you have to prove it is a rectangle. Draw the figure, everybody. A, B, C, D. Okay, diagonals are equal. Given, let in parallelogram A, B, C, D, AC equal to BD. Required to prove A, B, C, D is a rectangle. Okay. So, in parallelogram, if one of the angles is 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. Okay. Whenever you have to show a parallelogram is a rectangle, so nothing else, you have to show one of the angles of the parallelogram is 90 degree. You suppose you show that angle A is 90 degree. Then what happens? Opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram, then angle C is also 90 degree. Okay. And you know that sum of adjacent angles is 180 degree, means angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree. Angle A is 90, then angle B equal to 180 minus 90. Again, we get angle B equal to 90. And of angle B, both are opposite angles. Angle B is 90, then angle D also be 90 degree. In this way, we can show that each angle of the parallelogram is 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. So, nothing else, only one of the angles of the parallelogram you have to show 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. So, how to show parallelogram given diagonals equal to nothing else? We have to prove triangle ABC and BAD, these two triangles are congruent. We have to show because opposite sides are equal. One common side we have and diagonals are equal. Okay, so by SSS criteria, both the triangles are congruent, then angle A equal to angle B. This angle A equal to angle B. But angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree, adjacent angles of parallelogram, and both are equal also, then each angle is what? 90 degree. Angle A equal to angle B, and angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree, then angle A equal to angle B equal to 90, means one of the angles of the parallelogram is 90, means ABCD is a rectangle. Okay, so first of all, we have to prove triangle ABC and triangle BAD both are congruent. Proof. in triangles ABC and BAD. Since BC equal to AD, opposite sides. Okay. AC equal to BD, that is B way, and AB equal to BA. So therefore, triangle ABC congruent to triangle BAD SSS criteria. So therefore, angle ABC equal to angle BAD CPCT. Okay, but angle ABC plus angle BAD equal to 180 degree adjacent angles of parallelogram. So then both are equal and sum of them is 180. So which angle? Angle ABC equal to angle BAD equal to 90 degree. So in parallelogram, if one of the angles is 90, you have shown, then it is a rectangle. You have to conclude. So since in parallelogram ABCD, angle ABC equal to 90 degree, so therefore ABCD is a rectangle. Prove. Visible or not? No, visible. So simple. This is also theorem. Question number 2. Have you written everybody? May I clean the board? Okay, thank you. Now thereafter, question number 3. Show that if diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other at right angles, then it is a rhombus. Show that if diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other at right angles, then it is a rhombus. Okay. Figure you have to draw. Quadrilateral ABCD. Diagonals bisect each other at right angles. Okay. Given you have to write, let in quadrilateral ABCD diagonals AC and BD bisect at right angles. Okay, diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect at right angles, then it is a rhombus. We have to prove, required to prove ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, ABCD is a rhombus. First of all, you have to prove ABCD is a parallelogram. How to prove? You know that in a quadrilateral, if diagonals bisect each other, okay, in a quadrilateral, if diagonals bisect each other, it is given in theorem number 8.7. Theorem number 8.7, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. So diagonals of this quadrilateral ABCD bisect each other, that's why it is a parallelogram. Okay, and in a parallelogram, if one pair of adjacent sides are equal, mean if you show that AB equal to BC, okay, or BC equal to CD, or CD equal to DA, or DA equal to AB, any one pair of adjacent sides are equal, if you show, then it becomes a rhombus. Suppose if AB equal to BC equal to 5 cm, AB equal to 5 cm, BC equal to 5 cm, opposite sides are also equal. So AB equal to DC equal to 5 cm, BC equal to AD equal to 5 cm. In such a way, we get each side of this parallelogram is 5 cm. So then it is a rhombus. So nothing else. First of all, you have to show it is a parallelogram by using that theorem 8.7. And thereafter, we have to show one pair of adjacent sides are equal. Okay, so part by part, first of all, you have to show it is a parallelogram. Thereafter, I will explain the mechanism how to show one pair of adjacent sides are equal. You have to write since what diagonals of quadrilateral ABCD bisect each other, therefore ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, and thereafter we have to show one of the adjacent sides are equal. How show that? Nothing else, we have to consider two adjacent triangles. Okay, AOB and BOC, there are two adjacent triangles. Okay, BOC, COD, another pair of adjacent triangles. COD, DOA, okay, third pair of adjacent triangles. And DOA, AOB also, one pair of, or a fourth pair of adjacent triangles. So we have to show one pair of adjacent triangles are congruent, then by CPCT, we can say that AB equal to BC. If we show that triangle AOB congruent to triangle COB, then AB equal to BC by CPCT. So in this way, one pair of adjacent side we have to show equal, then parallelogram becomes a rhombus. So how to show both the triangles are congruent? Triangle AOB and COB, let's see, OA equal to OC given, angle 1 equal to angle 2 90, each angle is 90 degree given, and OB is common, means side angle side. By using side angle side criteria of congruency, both the triangles are congruent, then by CPCT AB equal to BC. Okay, so write in triangles AOB and BOC since OA equal to OC from a given, angle 1 equal to angle 2 equal to 90 degree also given, bisect at right angle given, and OB equal to OB, that is common part. Therefore triangle AOB congruent to triangle AOB, it matching COB. SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent, so therefore you can say that AB equal to BC CPCT. Okay, now you have to conclude in parallelogram since divisible. You have to write above. Okay, now you have to conclude just. So since in parallelogram ABCD, AB equal to BC, when one pair of adjacent sides are equal, so therefore ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so what we have done, actually given in a quadrilateral diagonals bisect at right angles, then prove that it is a rhombus. Clear? So nothing else, we know the property of parallelogram and converse also. So according to theorem number 8.7, in a quadrilateral, if diagonals bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. Diagonals bisect each other given, that's why it is a parallelogram. Thereafter we have to consider two adjacent triangles, and thereafter we have to prove both the adjacent triangles are congruent. Then by CPCT we can say AB equal to BC, means ultimately we get one pair of adjacent sides of the parallelogram are equal, then ABCD is a rhombus. This is the mechanism. Clear? Okay. Now do this much only. Then after you have to proceed homework. You have to go through all the theorems, exercise homework, exercise 8.1, theorems, basic terms also, basic terms, theorems, and exercise 8.1, questions number 1, 2, 3. This thing you have to do at home. Basic terms means I have shown adjacent angles and adjacent sides, opposite angles, opposite sides, and the sum of interior angles of parallel 360. We have a theorem number 8.1. 8.1 you have shown here. And thereafter all the theorems you have to go through and you have to write in your class work copy, and then you have to start exercise 8.1. The basic terms you have to write, thereafter theorems you have to prove and write according to the syllabus, and then you start exercise. Clear? This much only. Thank you and have a nice day.